Hey, people. Okay, so today I want to continue talking about risks and how we humans relate to risking. So have you ever done something like new and it went awesome? Like it went well, it went better than you thought it would go. Like an experience of success that you were probably not expecting. And then you think like, wow, that went way better than I thought it would go. I better just stop right here. That's exactly what I'm experiencing right now. So if I back up a little bit, a few weeks ago I made a video that was all right, but I didn't like it. And then in my next video, I talked about like taking a risk of making that video and not liking it in that process. And then that second video went really well. Like I got tons of messages and texts and feedback, and it opened up lots of possibility in my coaching practice because I'm a coach, and I'll plug my coaching practice, Coaching Life Alchemy. And so I was like, wow, this was amazing. This went really well. And then back to like, ugh, like that went well. I better not push it. Like I don't want to make another one and then have it go back to sucking. So if I take a further step back from this perspective, it's interesting to see, like, okay, so I made a video a while ago that I didn't feel like it went well, so then I wanted to stop. And then I risked and made a second video that did went well, and I still felt like I wanted to stop. And that just seems insane. But I also can see many times in my life where I kind of like put myself in that equation. And it's insanity, and I kind of think people can relate to this. And why is that? Like, why do we put so many assumptions and stories on risks and leaps? And one of the reasons that I'm going to talk about today is that when we are looking ahead at doing something new or taking a leap, our brain only knows how to calculate and like instantly calculate the loss. Like, ugh, if I do this, I'm letting go of that, or I could risk this, or it could feel bad, or whatever. Our brain does not automatically go into calculating the possibility because we don't know the possibility. We have a historical experience of something we're attached to that we think we could lose, and that's why it feels so real and so scary. So, an example of this could be if I said, hey, what if you stopped watching TV for 6 months, or gave up good carbs, for, not healthy carbs, yummy carbs, for 6 months, or gave up like sitting around or complaining or something like that. Like I think most people go to like, oh no, I love TV, or like a holding on to kind of feeling, when because our brain automatically goes to like, but I know that, but I like that, but I have an experience of it that I want to keep. Versus, like, if we really played with the TV example, like, our brain can't calculate what we'd actually do with all that time. Like, oh, I'd have more time with my friends and family. I might sleep more. Maybe I would eat more consciously, and that would impact my health. Or I would read more. I'd be more educated. Something like that. So, although something would happen with all that time that we would have watched TV, for example, but our brain can't like factor that into the equation. So, if whenever we're in like a big leap or a risk, it's really natural to go to the fear of what will occur because that's how our brain is wired initially. There's all these possibilities that can come out of any choice, and not taking a risk is still a choice. Anyway, so I love this idea, and I love how much possibility it opens around doing something new and how we do something new. And working with a coach is one way to really stay on the possibility and like take those leaps and risks with like courage and a knowingness of what's possible versus getting stuck in almost the illusion and kind of silent voices of what's to be lost. And that's one thing I really love doing with people. So maybe your risk is even getting a coach. Isn't that a good one? So if that's something that you think would serve you, having somebody on your team to leap and risk and have those possibilities be bigger than the fears, call me, text me, let's work together. And whether we work together or not, like keep in mind where your brain thinks it's serving you or like protecting you, and it's not. You can still do whatever you want. So take the risk, make the leap, go big, and it's absolutely worth it to keep going even when it's scary. So until next week, big kiss. Bye.